If you're not yet using AI for your business, you're missing out. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how I used AI to help me create clock in and clock out buttons for employee timesheets. Now, to create these buttons, we're going to need macros. And while I love using macros by recording them, writing them is a bit trickier, and that's where AI is going to come in. So if you have Microsoft 365, you should now have access to CoPilot. And if not, you should be able to do this same exercise using ChatGPT or another AI. Here on my screen is a timesheet we created in a prior tutorial, which I'll leave a link to in the description of this video. And what I want to do is create a macro button that will find the current date and insert a timestamp in the corresponding cell, depending on whether the employee is clocking in or clocking out. Before I go on, it's important to note that macros can only be used via the Excel desktop app. Currently, they don't work with Excel mobile or Excel on the web. But what if your team is on the go, or you need something more seamless and powerful for your staff? Well, that's where the sponsor of this video comes in. Connect Team is an employee management app designed specifically for non-desk teams. With the Connect Team app, your employees can clock in and out right on their phones. You can even set up an auto clockout feature to automatically clock out an employee after a certain number of hours. The app will then automatically calculate hours worked, breaks, and overtime. Then there's their geofencing capabilities that allows you to see which job site your employee is clocking in and out from. So, whether you manage a team with different shifts in one location or out on the field, this will be such a time saver for everyone. Your team just downloads the app on their smartphone and they're good to go. What's more is you can start for free. If you have 10 users or less, it's free to use. More than 10 users, you can get a 14-day free trial, no credit card needed. So make sure to scan the QR code on your screen or go to the link in the description box and open your free Connect Team account today. And thank you, Connect Team, for sponsoring this video and supporting this channel. First thing we need to do is to save our timesheet workbook as an XLSM file. And this is a macro-enabled file type and is necessary to be able to run any macros. So we'll come to the File tab, we'll select Save a Copy, and from the File Type dropdown, we'll select XLSM and click Save. Now, if you're using Microsoft 365, you should now see this Copilot button somewhere in your Home tab. If you don't, double-check your Account tab to see if you need to run any updates. You also want to make sure that your Developer tab is available. So next, we need to click on the Copilot button. And when you do that, you're going to see some options that Excel thinks you may want to use as prompts. But for this example, we're going to create our own prompt. So here where it says Message Copilot is where we'll type in our prompt. And key to getting good feedback from your AI is to provide enough detail so that it knows what it is that you're trying to do. So for this prompt, I'll say, I want to create a macro that will allow someone to clock in. So the macro will need to search a list in cells A12 to A18 for the current day. Then, once it finds the correct date, it needs to apply Control plus Shift plus semicolon in a cell adjacent to the date. And the reason for the Control plus Shift plus semicolon command is because when you press those three at the same time, it automatically enters the current time in whatever cell you're in. So once we have our prompt, we'll click on the send arrow to submit it, and then we need to just wait a moment for Copilot to generate a response. And here is our response from Copilot. Now, if we scroll up to just below our message to Copilot, we can see the VBA code. So I'm going to select the code beginning where it says sub, all the way down to where it says end sub. And with all of that highlighted, I'm going to press Control C on my keyboard to copy it. And we'll go to the Developer tab and we'll open Visual Basic. And in the Insert tab, we'll insert a new module and press Control V to paste in the code. Now, if you look up here where it says sub clock in, this is the name of the macro. Now, for clarity, so that it matches the heading on the timesheet, I'm going to change the macro name to clock in before lunch. We'll click OK. So quick note here, if you're going to be making copies of the timesheet that you're using the macros in, you'll want to update which worksheet it's referencing. So here where it says WS, you'll want to update that to say WS equals active sheet. Save our macro and close it. Before we do anything else with this macro, I want to make sure that it works because, well, just AI is just not perfect yet. So in the Developer tab, click on Macros, select your macro, and press Run. And sure enough, today is Thursday, May 15th, and it's 4:51. Now, because our timesheet example has four opportunities for an employee to clock in and out, this means we're actually going to need four macros, and that's going to be one for each one of these clock in and out headings. Now, the easiest way to create the other macros will be to step back into your macros. So click Macros with the macro that we just created selected, press Step Into, and we'll copy everything. We'll again insert a new module and use Control V to paste the macro in. Now we're gonna make a couple of changes on here. We'll rename this one to Clock Out Before Lunch. Now, all of this code is the instructions that Excel needs to run the macro. So within this code, we need to identify the commands that specify the location of where the timestamp will be placed. And that's going to be here where it says define the column for time in before lunch, column B, followed by time column equals 2, and then again down here where it mentions column B again. Now here where it says define the column for time in before lunch in column B, and it's saying that it's in column 2, we're going to update this to say time out before lunch, and we'll update this to column C, and we'll change where it says time column equals 2 to 3. And here's why. Time out before lunch is located in column C, and it's also the third column in the area that we're searching through. So the date is column 1, time in before lunch is column 2, time out before lunch is column 3, and so forth. So as we update each of these macros, we have to make sure that each heading and each column location matches the layout of our sheet. And we'll update here too where it says insert current time in the adjacent cell in column B. We'll update this to column C. And we'll click to save. We'll exit the macro. And now let's see if this works. So click in macros again. We'll select the clock out before lunch. And this worked perfectly. So now we want to do the same exercise for the other macros. So open macros again. We'll click on clock out before lunch. Step into, we'll copy this one. Insert new module, paste the new module. And we'll change the title to clock in after lunch, and we'll make the same changes that we made before to reference the new column. So we'll define the column for time in after lunch. And this is now column D. And the time column is now column 4. And we'll come over here and change this to column D. And we'll save this one. I'm going to skip testing this since it worked the last time. So we'll make the fourth macro, selecting everything and pressing Control C on our keyboard to copy it. We'll insert a new module, use Control V to paste it. And for its title, instead of clock out after lunch, why don't we change this to clock out for the day? We'll just update this to clock out after lunch. This is now column E. Time column will be the fifth column. We'll update that down here too. And we'll save this one as well. And let's close this. And let's test our other macros. So we'll clock in after lunch. That's working perfectly. We'll do our other macro, clock out for the day. And they all fill in. And of course, this says we only worked 3 minutes, but obviously we're just testing the macros. So let's delete these entries. And the next thing we want to do is to create buttons for our employees to be able to clock in and out. So still in the Developer tab, under Controls, we'll look for Inserts, and there's an option here for a Form Control button. So we'll click on this, and we'll just insert it somewhere over here to the right. And when we do this, the list of macros opens up. And this is so that we can pick one of the macros to assign to the button. So the first one we want to do is, of course, clock in before lunch. And we'll click OK. And then in it, we can just change its title to say clock in before lunch. And let's test this by clicking to press our new button. And it worked perfectly. And we're going to repeat this for the other four buttons. And you can lay them out however you prefer. I'm just lining them all up one above the other. So the next one will be to clock out before lunch. So we'll select the corresponding macro, click OK. Change the name on this one as well. Clock out before lunch. Click to exit out of it. We'll insert the next one, selecting the corresponding macro again. So we will clock in after lunch. Click OK. Clock in after lunch. And our final macro, or our final macro button, we'll clock out for the day and we'll call it clock out. For the day. And if you need to move these, you can right click on them and kind of select it and move it about. So let's try all these. We'll clock in before lunch, clock out to go to lunch, then they clock in after lunch, and then they clock out for the day. Thanks for watching, and for more tutorials like this, click on these links. Thanks.